Ahoy there, pirates. Amir, or One Falcon, here from Rare Thief. The Merchant Alliance has recently caught a few tough breaks. Some shipments of cargo have not reached their destinations, and the vessels carrying the shipments are lost at sea. Due to these unfortunate events, the Merchant Alliance is in need of some help, and they will handsomely reward any pirate who can hunt down their lost ships and recover the manifests aboard them. You can embark on this investigation by starting one of the new Lost Shipment Voyages. This voyage will have you following a lost ship's trade route while searching for clues to the ship's whereabouts along the way. The clues will ultimately lead to the lost vessel's location, now shipwrecked in the ocean, and its manifest. Master sleuths will also find the captain's key during the voyage. You can use the captain's key to access a vast pile of cargo held in the captain's cabin of the lost shipwreck. To purchase the voyage, you can either speak with Lorena or the Merchant Alliance. Getting the voyage from Lorena is free, but the voyage will be a lower ranked voyage. To purchase the voyage from the Merchant Alliance, you'll need to at least have a reputation level of 25 with the trading company. Also keep in mind, if you purchase the voyage from the Merchant Alliance, the number of clues you'll discover and the loot you will retrieve will vary depending on your reputation level. You can expect to find more clues and treasure the higher your Merchant Alliance reputation is. It is possible to find as many as 4 clues before finally finding the lost shipwreck. Before leaving the outpost with your voyage, it wouldn't hurt to throw up a Merchant Alliance emissary flag. You will be picking up dozens of Merchant Alliance crates along the way that will raise your emissary grade and make the payout even larger when you eventually turn in the collected loot. Upon voting on and starting the voyage, you will receive one quest. This quest will be a trade route map for the missing delivery. You will first want to look at the two most important pieces of information on the trade route map, the origin island and the destination island. You can find them both labeled on the bottom of the trade route map. Once you know where the origin island is, sail on over to it to begin your investigation. If you start the voyage at an outpost, you could get really lucky and already be at the origin island. Once in position at the origin island, base your ship in the direction that the trade route travels towards the destination island. From the origin island, you will be following the ship's plotted course towards its destination while keeping an eye on the horizon for clues about the lost ship's travels. It is possible to discover the shipwreck without finding any of the clues, though you will miss out on tons of Merchant Alliance treasure and a chance at finding the captain's key. The final clue will also help you triangulate the location of the lost shipwreck. So how do we go about finding that first clue? The first clue to discover will always be found inside a merchant barrel floating in the sea. You will find the merchant barrel along other floating debris, resource barrels, and Merchant Alliance crates in the water underneath a large circle of seagulls. When we say large, we mean the amount of seagulls found over merchant shipwrecks large. You should be able to see the flock of seagulls from the origin island as you scan the horizon with your spyglass if you are facing the correct direction. From the origin island, sail towards the flock of seagulls, or sail along the trade route until you find the flock of seagulls floating above the clue site. The flock of seagulls should be found in the first fourth of the trade route. If you are past that point, you have probably passed the first clue site. Once you are at the clue site, jump into the water and inspect the debris. Look for a resource barrel with blue stripes on it. This new kind of resource barrel is the merchant barrel. Inside will be your first clue, which is a curious note. It will be added to your quest radial next to the trade route map. You'll also want to keep an eye out for the captain's key floating in the water at the clue site. It will glint blue from a distance and not yellow like other treasure. The captain's key can spawn at any of the clue sites, even the first one. If you don't find it at the first clue site, keep it in mind as you search the following ones. As you discover clues, your trade route map will track them by showing a marker on their found location. This will help you keep track of which clue sites you've already visited. The clues you gather along the voyage will be log entries from the Lost Crew's journal. You will be following along their journey as they log travels. Each clue you pick up will direct you to the next clue until you pick up the final clue. If you're having difficulty finding the first clue site, use your spyglass. We found using our spyglass to locate the seagulls to be of great help. With your first clue in hand, read it to discover the next location you should sail to. There are a handful of different types of clues you can encounter during this voyage. If the clue is a log entry that mentions an island, sail to that island. This clue is an island clue. Once on the island, you will want to walk along the island's beaches looking for a clue in a bottle. The clue in the bottle will glint blue from a distance instead of the usual yellow. You will also find the clue in the bottle surrounded by Merchant Alliance crates and wooden debris, making it easier to spot on the beach. You shouldn't need to head inland to find the clue. Once you find the clue in the bottle, pick it up and you'll have your next clue in hand. You'll also be ambushed by a group of skeletons, so prepare for battle. If the clue is a log entry that mentions map coordinates, sail to those coordinates. This clue is a sea clue. The clue will be floating in the sea in a bottle underneath a tiny flock of seagulls and next to Merchant Alliance loot and wooden debris. It will be somewhere inside the coordinates given in the clue. Again, use that spyglass. You'll be surprised how much it helps track down those seagulls flying above your next clue. If you're struggling to find the tiny flock of seagulls and floating debris in the coordinates, park your ship in the middle of the coordinates, go up to your crow's nest, and scan the horizon in all directions with your spyglass. If the clue is a log entry that mentions a pirate's name and an island, sail to the island and find the NPC who resides there. This clue is an island resident clue. Once on the island, you will want to track down the NPC living there. Sometimes the island can be a seapost, making it easy to find the NPC. Once you find the NPC, talk to them. Choose the first dialogue option available to acquire the next clue from them. They will give you the clue after you are done speaking to them. If the clue is a map of a circled island, sail on over to that island. This clue is a circle map clue. Once on the island, you will want to head over to the circled area. Comb the beaches of the circled part of the island looking for the clue in a bottle. Once you find it, pick up the clue in the bottle to continue on to your next step. If the clue mentions neither an island nor coordinates and isn't a map, that means there are no more clues to be found. You have discovered the final clue. Instead, the clue will say things like near the end and no more distractions. From the final clue site, you should sail towards the destination island until you run into the shipwreck. If you are struggling to find any clues, remember that the clue site should roughly trace the route displayed on the trade route map. If you find yourself nowhere near the trade route or any of the islands shown on the trade route map, you have strayed too far away. Back to finding the shipwreck. If you are heading from the final clue site or just sailing along the latter half of the trade route, you'll want to keep an eye out for a small flock of seagulls. Not the usual large amount of seagulls you might expect from an emergent shipwreck. The lost shipwreck you are looking for will be beneath this small flock of seagulls. Once at the lost shipwreck, it's time to find that merchant's manifest. You'll know you're at the correct shipwreck because you'll get a new music cue for the voyage when you dive down to it, and the captain's cabin door of the shipwreck will be closed shut. The merchant's manifest will be in the hands of an ill-fated captain somewhere on the shipwreck. The skeleton holding the merchant's manifest can be anywhere on the shipwreck. Be sure to check behind the captain's cabin, in the crow's nest, on the deck, and in the shipwreck's hull. Picking up the manifest will complete the voyage. You can sell the merchant's manifest for gold and progress toward the manifestation accommodation. Depending on the voyage rank, the merchant's manifest can sell anywhere between 1600 gold and 4000 gold. If you have the captain's key, don't forget to use it on the shipwreck's captain's cabin. You want to unlock the door and grab all the loot stored within it. You can sell the captain's key, of course, but the loot inside the cabin is worth much more than that one key. Selling the merchant's manifest a total of 20 times to the Merchant Alliance will unlock the Merchant Pathfinder sails that Lorena currently has in stock. Opening 50 captain's cabins with a captain's key will unlock the Golden Gatherer merchant sails. That about covers everything you need to know about the voyage. Find your origin, track down the clues while looking for the captain's key, locate the shipwreck, and reap the rewards. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below. Thanks for watching!